What is up, everyone? Good morning. We've got the sun. We've got the waves. The waves are quite small today. We've got the coffee. Today is going to be a good day. Oh, God, that's good. Coffee is so good. So the plan for today is I was supposed to be training with someone, doing like a little bit of a collaboration, but she had to postpone until next week, which is a little bit annoying because I kind of changed my routine around a little bit this week, my training split to accommodate for that. So now I'm like in two minds of what to train. Ideally, I'd like to have two arm days in a week, but given it's Thursday now, I'm not going to be able to make that happen. So today it's looking like it's going to be a bit of chest and shoulders. Tomorrow I'll probably just do back and maybe a little bit of light biceps, and then Saturday will be arms and abs. So that's the plan. This morning the weight was 101.7, so I've gone up slightly, but when I look in the mirror I look a little bit leaner, I think. You probably won't be able to tell right now, but obviously I look at myself all the time, so I think I maybe look a little bit leaner. Either way, I'm not too concerned about that, because whenever you do like a heavier session, when you train something like back or oh, hang on, I got a dog up to some funny business. What are you doing? Hey. Digging for gold. Anyway, what was I saying? Whenever you train back or like legs or something which is quite taxing on the body, you can always expect sort of higher cortisol levels, and your body's just going to retain a little bit more water because of that. Also, I'm currently on a 6-day training split, which is probably suboptimal. I'll probably make more progress if I was training 5 days a week. Like when I wake up in the morning, like I just feel my whole body is just so sore pretty much every single day. One thing that I am going to change is the walking. Right now I've been doing close to 2 hours of walking every single day. Sometimes I don't make 2 hours, but always doing at least an hour. But my legs are just sore all the time. So what I'm going to do instead is just do a maximum of 1 hour walking. So obviously I'm at the beach now. I'm going to have this coffee. I'm going to do 30 minutes now, and I'll probably do a 30 minute walk at sunset. And that's me. That's my cardio and my walking done, because my legs are just so sore. And if you end up doing too much cardio, you can end up just shrinking your legs. You can end up losing muscle. So some people do better with like no cardio or just a bit of cardio. Oh, I got another friend. So normal. Yeah, there's dogs everywhere. Yeah, so that's the plan. I'm going to reduce the cardio slightly, try and save the legs, and gonna get a massive chest today. Chest, maybe a slight bit of shoulders, although I don't really care about shoulders that much. So I'm gonna enjoy this now. Okay guys, so today we're working the chesticles again. I feel like I train chest all the time, but I don't mind because I like it. I'm going to do this exercise again. I don't know who's been on here, but it's so high. This is a bit high up, but honestly, I'm too lazy to change it. So this is like, after this set, I'll research the name of this exercise, but it's essentially the opposite of a shrug. I'm letting my body sink down between my arms and then using muscles in my chest to lift me back up. Mm. Mm. Oh, I feel a bit of pain in my elbow, which is not good. Okay, so this exercise is called, well, there's a few names for it, but the one that I'm gonna go with is straight arm dip, because it's a dip, but your arms are straight, so that kind of makes sense. What does it say here? Muscle groups targeted, trapezius, serratus anterior, pectoralis major, which is obviously your chest, anterior deltoid, and core stabilizers. Benefits: build scapular strength and awareness, improves posture, enhances performance in movements like L-sits, pull-ups, rows, helps balance upper trap development. Yeah, so depending on how you angle your body on the dip, is you can change the focus from the front to the back. And what I'm trying to do here is use my chest as much as possible. I'm almost like leaning forward a bit. Instead of being more upright and using my back muscles to lift me up, I'm trying to come forwards and let my chest do all the work. So depending on how you angle the body, will change which muscles you're working. Oh, I'm getting some elbow pain, which is not good. Okay, set number three. I might have to abandon this exercise. I might even have to train something else because I'm getting some pain in my elbow, which is not a good pain. I find if you keep your abs contracted on this one, it also helps target the chest. Oh, yeah, that feels good. So this is the current condition. This is what we're dealing with. Like, I weigh a little bit heavier than yesterday, but I think I look a little bit better. I did have 3 meals yesterday instead of 2. I had the eggs in the morning. I also had a few bananas, which I've not been eating. So that's a little bit more carbs, but we're making progress. That's the main thing. It's not as fast as I'd like it to be. Where every time I've got lean, I've just been going along and it's felt like nothing's happening. And then you just have a sudden drop and you're like, whoa. And then you plateau again for ages and then a drop again. That seems to be how every time I've changed my physique, either with building muscle or losing fat, it's always been like that. It's never in a straight line that you'd expect. Okay, so next exercise is an incline dumbbell press. Pretty much every single chest workout, I'll do some kind of incline press, whether it's a barbell or dumbbell or machine. I don't really like the machine incline press here, so we're doing dumbbells. The angle of the bench is a little bit less than the fixed angle of the barbell bench press. And I'm just doing that to get a bit more variety. It's a very slight incline, but for me, I just feel like that's better than if I go to like a 45 degree angle, because it brings the shoulders in more. Mm. Okay, set two. I'm not going to failure on this because my body just feels so fatigued. And like I'm feeling pains in my my elbow and stuff. It's just a sign that I'm probably a little bit under-recovered. But it should be fine as long as I don't push too hard. Last step. So you'll notice there, I'm not really going that heavy, but I'm really focusing on like where I want to target, okay? So I'm trying to target my upper chest. So I'm really thinking about that. When I'm pressing up, I'm really making sure I've got that mind-muscle connection and that part here, that's what I'm working. It's really not about the weight, but it's how you lift and how you perform the weight. Okay, now dumbbell crush press. This is such an underrated chest exercise. Really want to feel the squeeze at the top. Okay, so set two. On this one, notice the path that the dumbbells take. Like my starting position, the dumbbells are over my head. But as I come down, the dumbbells are over my chest. So I'm not pushing directly up. It's almost like the path that the dumbbells take is on an arc. I think two sets is enough on there. Exercise number four, a single arm low to high cable fly. Really focusing on this part here, right? You should be able to see my chest working where we want it to. If you can't, then I'm not performing the exercise correctly or I'm not lean enough. But you should be able to see my chest contracting. Mm. 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 Okay, set two. So where you stand on this relative to where the cable starts makes a difference. Like you can see here, I'm fully stretched out. So I'm getting a greater range of motion. Whereas if I'm like this, it's a much shorter exercise, right? So you want to make sure where you stand, the starting position, this muscle is kind of stretched out here. Okay, next exercise, cable flies. Cable flies are very versatile because you can change the height of where the cable start from, but you can also angle your body differently. For example, I could be like this. I could be more upright. I feel this the best when my body is almost upright, like here. I'm getting a great stretch across my pecs right now. And then come in. Wow, feel that. Okay, set two. Okay, last set. Oh. Ah, good. Okay, so that's my chest worked. Now I'm just going to do a little bit of shoulders. Now this is called a dumbbell Y raise, I think is the proper name for it. Depending on how you angle your body again, well, this can be more of a back exercise, but I actually want to target my side and rear delts. So because of that, I'm just going to change the angle of my body slightly. I don't want to work my back too much because I'm probably going to do back tomorrow. Okay, set two. You really don't need to go heavy on this exercise. This is one where it's really about how you perform the exercise rather than the weight that you do. The advantage of lying on a bench like this is it stops you. When a lot of people do lateral raises, they're swinging like this, and you're really just making the exercise easier, and you're not performing the exercise correctly, basically. But when you've got your chest fixed to a bench, you take out all the momentum, and you can really focus on working the muscle. Okay, set three. Another benefit of this exercise is it really helps improve posture. I can feel my shoulder blades are being pulled back more. And the better your posture is, the better your chest will look. So some of you probably don't need to train chest anymore. Probably need to work on you doing exercises which improve your posture, because then that'll just make your chest look bigger. Ah, done. So that's what? Five exercises for chest, one for shoulders. I would say that's a productive workout done.
All right, guys, we've got today's meals. What time is it? It's like fucking 1:15. I honestly feel a little bit lightheaded because I haven't eaten yet. So for lunch, we have salmon, egg, rice, and vegetables. That looks like soy sauce, I'm guessing. And then for dinner, we have chicken, this one looks like tagliatelle pasta, salad, some, I don't know what that is. Looks quite good, smells good. Let me have a look at the menu. So the salmon is salmon kabayaki with rice. And then the chicken pasta is diced parsley chicken with bechamel sauce and fettuccine. Sounds very Italian. They did mess up because I told them I don't eat pasta, and they were like, okay, we won't send you pasta, but they have done. So they messed up there, but that's fine because tonight I'm going to all you can eat barbecue place. I know I said I wouldn't go there, but honestly, I just don't want to give it up, you know? I can't give up all you can eat steak. It's a tradition I go pretty much every single week. So yeah, I'm just gonna have one of these meals. Corey, the man behind the camera, can have this one. And yeah, let's make it up. Okay, so this is the meal. I'll tell you the stats in a second. I'm gonna give you a taste test, but if you have access to a good meal prep company and you've got the budget for it, I would highly recommend it. Like, these meals are pretty cheap. I mean, depending on where you live in the world, they're not gonna be this cheap, but it works out at $6.30 per meal. Now, I'll tell you the stats. So for the salmon, 60 protein, 32 fats, 46 carbs, 652 calories. So also, my calories and macros are already worked out. I don't need to think about what I'm gonna eat. I just come home every day, my meals are delivered, and I just put them in the microwave. Obviously, the microwave is suboptimal, but if everything else is right, no worries. And yeah, I got my meal. I need some salt, actually. The problem with a lot of meal prep companies is they don't deliver you food often enough. Like, this food's getting delivered every day, so it's always fresh. But if you get meal prep delivered like once a week, you know, those meals at the end of the week are just not gonna be tasting good at all. Now, I'll be honest, this is egg, apparently. It's looking a little bit sus. I don't know what's going on here with this egg. That's not looking too good. It tastes okay. Let's try the real stuff. Try the salmon. Yeah, this is good.